Yes, in this video, we are going to see how reading of information or writing in any way, how an instruction is fetched from the memory and given to the programming logic. So how it can, what are all the registers which are affected, how the control signals functions. So we take a small example and we'll see. Before that, we'll see just how it can be the registers and the control signals are organized. In the picture first one, which says the hardware model. That is, we group like this, accumulator, arithmetic logic, flag, instruction decoder, register array, and these are all the address bus and data bus which are connected. So this works as a communication line between the microprocessor and the main memory. And these are the control signals which helps in communication. So along with this, it combined together and works, as well as it helps in operation, smooth operation of this. So for that, it generated timings, etc., and clock signals. Here, this you can say it as a programming model, because the same thing is given here, but why it is given as a programming model is they are all used in the instruction set. So it is available, the data present, B, C, D, accumulator, flag, they are all available for the user to do coding. So they can do programs using these registers. So that is why it is set as programming model. And this is nothing but the flag register. Here, this is a flag register which is given here separately. So we already know 5 flag registers or flag bits are there. They are all carry bit, parity bit, auxiliary carry, 0 bit, and sign bit. The functions already we have seen in the previous video. But anyway, while taking the next lessons, we will see how all these bits are affected and how they help in taking a decision in a program. So we'll take an example, which is nothing but reading an input 4F, the instruction 4F from the main memory and reading into the microprocessor. So what are all the steps involved? That is what we are going to see in this video. So this is the main memory. You can imagine this like a paper, where these are all the lines. So each line is one line you can write. So here 2000, it is an address. So which line? The first line, second line, third line, like that you will say. So in order to identify the line, we call it as an address. So 2000, 2001, 2002, this will say which line you are there. So let us imagine we are going to read the 2005 address, the data 4F is present. So how it is going to be read into the microprocessor? That is what we are going to see here. These are all the internal circuits. And here the memory is connected only through the address bus and data bus. So that is why it is said as separate. So control unit is separate. Then they also communicate with these lines, okay? Control bus lines and control signals. Here, these are all the internal ports, arithmetic logic units, instruction decoder, and the register arrays. Now, what happens when it is going to read? First, in the program counter, this address from which it is going to read the instruction that will be placed, which is nothing but 2005. It is a 16 bit because 2 is represented with 4 bits, 0 is represented with 4 bits, again this 4 bits and this 4 bits. So put together 16. So each address is a 16 bit address. And then data stored is a 8 bit data. Here 4F. For this 4 bits and for F 4 bits. So totally 8 bits. The data stored in the memory is 4 bit, whereas the address is 16 bit. So that is why we have address lines also A0 to A15. Okay, and data is 8 bit. Now, the microprocessor places a 16 bit memory address from the program counter, because that is what the next line we are going to read. Let us imagine we have programs. Now the next line to be read is this 2005, that is placed in the program counter, because program counter always point to the memory which is to be read as the next line. So now 2005 is placed. Now it takes the data 4F and it is placed on the data bus. Okay, now it has to indicate that it is a read signal, not It is not writing anything. It is reading from this. So the read signal is low yet, active low. So it indicates that now it is going to read data from the respective address and then placed on the database. Now this data which is placed on the database is placed in the instruction decoder through this internal database. Internal database is nothing but the communication line which connects all these things. So the byte from the memory location is placed on the database. The byte is placed in the instruction decoder, which decodes the instruction and further do what is mentioned on that. What is mentioned in that move C, A, which is nothing but move the content of accumulator to C register. That is the meaning of this. That will be carried over as the next step. So, but initially opcode is fetched. So what is opcode fetched? This 4F is fetched. And then it is placed on the instruction. Why it has to be placed on the instruction decoder? Because this is a single byte. Okay, 4F. Single byte is 8-bit. 1 8-bit is single byte, 1 bit. If it has 2 8-bits, then we call it as a 2-byte instruction. But this is a single byte instruction. But there are cases where 2-byte instructions are there, 3-byte instructions are there. So all those 3-byte has to be read in order to complete that instruction. So in that case, the instruction decoder will understand whether it is a single byte or a 2-byte and 3-byte. In case of 2-byte, it will read the next data which is placed in the next address also. So put together only, it completes a one full instruction. If it is a 3-byte, then it will read this data placed on this line, the next line, and the next line. So 3 times the memory will be read and the instruction reading will be complete. Then only it will complete the full instruction complete. So that is why the decoder, what the decoder will do, it will understand whether it is a single byte instruction or 2-byte instruction or 3-byte instruction, and accordingly it will carry over the next job. So that is why, but that's the main purpose of the instruction decoder. And then whatever is mentioned in that, that will be carried over, which is nothing but moving the data from the accumulator to the C register. That will be done. Now we'll see the timing diagram. A timing diagram consists of, you can draw it with the timings, like how many milliseconds it will carry for one clock pulse. Here one clock period is said to be T1 and the second clock is T2 and so on. So this clock pulse only we call it as a clock period, that is T1, T2, T3. So an opcode fetch, in general, an opcode fetch takes 4 T cycles, that is 4 clock periods. So the first clock period, what it will do? Second clock period, what it will do? That is what we are going to see here. So here the address lines is given, and this is also data, both as well as address. And then this is address slash enable signal, IO slash mbar signal, or debar. These all together act together to fetch the data. So how it do? In the first clock period, okay, here the address is placed. That is higher order address is placed on A to, this is the higher order, A to A15. So in that 20H, what is higher order? If you take this address, this is called lower order and this is called higher order. That is 20 is called the right left hand side 8 bits. This is said to be higher order, and the right hand side, these two are said to be lower order. Anyway, we know that this is 4-bit, this is 4-bit, 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 put together 16-bit. So these two are 8-bits and these two are 8-bits. Here, this is lower order and this is higher order. That is least significant bit and most significant bit. So first, the address, higher order data, that is most significant bit is placed, that is 20H. Then the lower order, here 0 to 7, the least significant bit, which is nothing but 0-5 is placed. Then ALE goes high, stating that the data present here is only address, not the data, that is instruction. So here, the whatever is placed here will be recognized as the memory address. Then this goes low, indicating that it is going to read from the memory. We are going to read from the main memory. So for that, in order to indicate that, yeah, this goes, the same line is used for, the signal is used for both, indicating whether the data is reading or writing from the main memory or from the IO device. So when it goes low, indicates here, it indicates that M bar. So which indicates it is an active low. So when it goes low, it means whatever operation that is carried over from the memory. Then RD bar, this goes high. Here it says not reading, but when it goes slow, it says that it is reading from the memory. Now we'll see how these synchronize in order to read it. Now initially, first the address is placed and ALE goes indicating this is an address, and then this goes slow indicating it is memory. Now it is reading from memory. Now the program counter places this data on the address bus. Now the pointer is pointing to this. Now it is placed. The pointer moved here. That is 4F. Now the data present is 4F. This. Now this is taken and placed in the during the next T2 cycle. Next cycle, it is placed. The date it between D0 to D7. That is same A0 to A7. The data is placed. So it indicates that now how it will be read. When the read signal goes low, now it starts reading. It knows that after the read signal goes low, it knows that it has to read from the main memory. So from this, it knows it is from memory, and then where it will put the data on the D0 to D7. Whatever it is reading, that will be placed. And then now this is said to be opcode fetch. This is the opcode, so that is fetched. Then at T4, it will be placed on the instruction decoder. As we have seen, the data is placed and it will be read by the, it will be placed on the instruction decoder. Demultiplexing the bus. So what do you mean by demultiplexing? So the same signal, that is same lines, A0, normally it consists of address lines A0 to A7 and A8 to A15. So put together 16 address lines are there. How the same lines are used for both address as well as reading of data. So how the microprocessor carry over that? That is what just now we have seen, that is using the ALE signal. So ALE, now if you see the internal logic, see there is a demultiplexer. So what is here? In the previous diagram, the address on the higher order 20H remains on the bus for 3 clock periods. This is what? The data remains there for 3 clock periods. Then, but the lower order address 05 is lost after the first clock period. Here, after this first clock period, this is ours. Here data is placed now. So the address needs to be latched for identifying. So in this case, what happens? We lost the data. 05 is lost here. Because in this, automatically, when it reads the read signal, the data is placed on that. So this 05 is lost, but it should not be lost. It should be there for some period. So how it can be achieved both? So for that, we need the address needs to be latched for identifying the memory address. If the bus AD7 to AD0, that is these lines, is used to identify memory location, the address will change to 24F. If you don't latch, what happens? Now it becomes 20 and 4F. Now what happens? The microprocessor will go to 24F. That is 24F memory also there. It will go there. So in, but it should not be there. It should read 2005 only. So it is used to identify memory 2005. The address will change to 2004FH. After the first clock period itself, it will change. That is 24F. Now this will be considered as address, but it should not happen. So the above situation brings the necessity of demultiplexing the address bus. For that, we go for ALE signal, address latch enable, that used to latch chip. So this is a chip, latching a chip, 74LS373. That is used for multiplexing and demultiplexing. So at T1, the ALE goes high. Okay, at T1, it goes high and the latch is transparent. What do you mean by transparent? Meaning output changes, the meaning the output changes according to the input. So what happens? So during T1, the output of the latch is 05. At first itself, it will be 05. Then when the ALE goes low, the data by 05 is latched until next ALE and the output of the latch. So it represents the lower order bus AD0 to AM after latching the option. So for example, here address latch enable, here it is connected to this chip 74LS373. Here it's a D flip-flop, here it is latched. So when it is high only, this will act. Okay. So when it is high, whatever is placed on that, it will be kept. That is A0 to A7, that is 2005, that will come here. When it goes low, it indicates that This latch will not enable. Now here this line is connected. Now it is directly connected. Now when it is high, whatever is given here, it goes here. It means the data present 05 means 05 goes here. But once it is go low, the whole thing will be deactivate, and whatever is placed on the data bus will not affect the, will not come here. So here it goes, and the data placed is the data from the memory, it is placed on this line. See here the direction it is given as 4 of us. So from the memory, that is 0100, it is 4, and this is F. That is placed, and it will be received by the data bus, and this will be taken to the, now the flow will be in this direction, not towards this. So that is why we call these address lines only from A0 to A7 are both bidirectional. So we'll see the concept of instruction cycle, machine cycle, and T state. Instruction cycle, it is the time required to complete the execution of one full instruction. It consists of 1 to 6 machine cycle depending on the instruction type. What we have seen is this is a one machine cycle. It consists of four T states, whereas this is a single byte and it is only an opcode byte. Whereas sometimes there are 2 byte instruction, 3 byte instruction. So for that it may need 3 machine cycles or 2 machine cycle. That is the meaning of this. So 1 to 6 machine cycle is also there. Machine cycle, the time required to complete one operation of accessing memory or IO or acknowledging an external request. This may consist of 3 to 6 T states. Minimum is 3 T states. Then T state, one subdivision of the operation performed in one clock period. That is what? Subdivision. This is what we are saying. This put together, for this opcode fetch, it needs 4 T states, which is nothing but one machine cycle.